Welcome to another episode of series Gardens of India and vegetables, specifically vegetables of India in Texas. Today we are covering the Hanuman Temple's vegetable garden. As you guys know, we have a huge Hanuman Temple here in Texas, Dallas, Texas, Frisco, Texas, and we are all volunteers at the temple, and we have a nice volunteer garden, temple vegetable garden, where we use whatever vegetables that come from here for Annadhanam and all of that on Saturdays. Before COVID times, where we used to have every Saturday Annadhanams, now we also use it for in the canteen for sambar rice and all of these other items that volunteers make and sell in the canteen area, so that we can get some funds to the temple. Ground the bilvam plant. You see, it's grown very big, and a few other plants are here. Hardy hibiscus, the pink one.
We'll use it for puja.
They use it for puja here. There are a bunch of these plants up here, so they use hibiscus, some hardy hibiscus, some ganer plants, some plumerias. You see, they have all of this in the parking lot, up around the parking lot, which they use for the puja. Hibiscus are here. They are just there enough for regular puja, nitya puja. But neem and
peepal
tree. So there's a reason why they put these two trees together over here. Well, Shivaji, do you know why they put these two plants together in the ground here?
Peepal is symbol of Mahavishnu, and neem is symbol of Mahalakshmi. So we used to pray them.
So this is like Mahavishnu and Mahalakshmi together. Excellent. Very good. Thank you. See, as you see, this is the temple, and this is the temple yard in the front yard. There's still work going on. So that's why we still have a little bit here and there construction material. But these plants are in the ground. So it's very interesting. A lot of us have said we
those
have peepal trees.
Well.
These are medicinal. They have medicinal powers. Neem, as you know, everybody knows, peepal also has medicinal powers,
yes,
to it.
It's helpful for pregnant women.
Yes, pregnant women. Excellent. Thank you, Shivaji. You see, there is Avadumbaram plant in the ground here in the temple area, and it is right right above that is Lord Dattatreya's statue also. So if you see, if you do Annagavratams here, so if you do in the front of Avadumbaram tree, the saying is that it is one time is equal to doing it 100 times, and we've started doing Annagavratas like that. So this is the Dattatreya plant, which you've seen in a lot of other videos, but this is in the ground and it's grown so big, and here it's right behind the temple. So next time you visit the temple, you can do pradakshina or just look at the tree, so you can benefit from the vibrations around it. What is the significance of the Avadumbaram tree and Dattatreya, Shivaji?
Actually, which is help for the all the skin diseases.
Okay, the Avadharam, they use the leaves, is it?
Leaves.
Oh, for
it's
all the
proven
skin.
In our history as well. Okay. So after Narasimha killed Hiranyakashipu, he went, got the relief for the pain for his fingers. So he reaches to Avadumbara tree. He make this as a juice and he applied for that.
That is the saying. So the saying is that Lord Narasimha Swami, after the samhara of Hiranyakashipu, has used Avadumbaram leaves juice to cure his hands. I know it is very interesting to go back to mythology and know a little bit about it when we see our plants. So it is Lord Narasimha Swami's also favorite plant, I would say, and Lord Dattatreya is also a very friend. Thank you, Shivaji, for telling us a little bit more about Avadumbaram plant. This is where they use all the vegetables that we grow from the yard. over here. We have a few grape plants over here. So I was going to go over and show you a few of around the temple. And this is the canteen. Grapes from the temple. Very sweet green grapes. I know once Swamiji gave us all as prasadam for one of the pujas. So if you look. So grapes here in Texas, Frisco, Texas. They are light brown. This is one plant, two plants up here. And this is in the foyer area, if you see. And there are a lot more plants like that, around close to 5 to 6 plants. So grapes here in Texas, just similar to California, I would say. Here. They're very heavy and beautiful plants actually. And if you notice, Shivaji is showing us a lot of them. Excellent. They just use this orange trellis to grow this. Very, very beautiful grape plant. See, the grapes are amazing. The green over here, they slowly turn into the pink over there.
It helps to feed rabbits and...
Oh, you feed these to the rabbits?
Yes.
Excellent. So they stay away from the vegetable plants actually. So there's a natural way of helping them. I hope you get inspired and do your own veggie and fruit garden. Just like us here at the Dallas, Texas area. And you can even grow grapes very easily. So this is a hardy plant which we leave it outside. We don't do anything extra other than giving it the regular Jeevamritam and other compost that we create from the temple garden. Have to even cover them, they're just left as is in the ground, so we can have awesome grapes coming up. It's a beautiful vine. So as you've seen, there's a lot to learn from the temple garden because there's a different techniques of farming that we have learnt. And some of us come here for Shivaji whenever he takes a lesson. So you can check. I'll ask to see if there is a website where they can put some information about a couple of lines about what is being done here. So you all can benefit from the temple site too. Do, as you see, the backdrop, I have the huge Kari Siddhi Hanuman temple. So we are blessed by Lord Hanuman with this beautiful garden where we can do seva. If you want to volunteer, please sign up. Now is not the time during COVID, but after COVID, you can always volunteer a few hours over here and benefit and do seva and feel happy that you're doing your own farming here too, if you don't have a area where you can farm. So thank you so much for seeing this episode and liking it and subscribing to it. Thank you very much. And until another episode, thank you.